first show.
On today's show, we look at a recap of last weekend's Breakaway Fest, return of Dune Section, and at the end of the show, we will announce the 2017 Homecoming Court.
Eight F-15 fighter planes were flown to Wright-Patterson Air Force Base in Greene County, Ohio, as a precautionary measure to protect the planes from high hurricane winds.
Student Council has been taking a local approach to hurricane relief and is working on a project with the deaf and hearing impaired students at our school to raise money for animals abandoned in Hurricane Harvey. Zenobia Chris interviewed a student to learn more.
Hello, I'm Marissa York. As you all know, Hurricane Harvey has devastated many areas in Texas. Many people are helping the people there, and UA would like to help too. Please join UAHS Student Council and the Deaf and Hard of Hearing students as we raise money to help displaced animals in the Houston area. Funds will be sent to aid an organization called Pets Alive, which is working to relocate animals that have been abandoned or separated from their families because of the disaster. Next week, on Tuesday, September 12th, and Wednesday, September 13th, students will stop by your sixth period class to collect spare change. The total collected will be announced on Friday, September 15th on Kickin It. At the homecoming game, students will be collecting money in the stands as they ask the community to match the funds that we've collected here at school. How can you help? Dig deep for change to donate.
Student Council is also teaming up with the Bear Den, and on Tuesday and Wednesday, if you wear the themes, you can send in a picture to UASC_1718. Or on Twitter at @UA_BearDen on Snapchat. And for every picture received, Student Council will donate $1 to the cause.
The UA speech and debate team will hold their first meeting of the year on Monday, September 11th after school in room 108. Snacks will be provided. See Mr. Camiotti or Ms. Burgess if you would like to learn more.
Environmental Club is also meeting Mondays after school in room 145. Club Cloud 9 Cure meets Thursdays at 7:30 a.m. in room 247, and starting September 12th, Math Club will meet Tuesdays after school in room 203.
Now let's kick it over to a Not Live Dugan and Kate.
Welcome to sports. I'm Dugan. If you're watching this, it means I'm currently missing my wisdom teeth, and my mom believes Tylenol will do the trick. So I'm probably in constant pain. Ohio State plays Oklahoma at home this week. The Buckeyes are hoping to beat the Sooners to make their record 2-0. In NFL news, week one starts, and we looked at which Ohio State alumni players to watch this weekend. Despite his six-game suspension, Ezekiel Elliott will play for the Cowboys week one, messing up some people's fantasy football strategies. Also, Marshon Lattimore will be playing for the Saints, Gerrion Conley will be playing for the Raiders, and Malik Hooker will be playing for the Colts. Catch them and more OSU alumni this weekend for week one of the NFL season. Now let's take a look at the UA top three plays of the week.
UA Sports. It's in the game.
Sophie Croce has a goal from the corner, leading the Field Hockey Bears to a victory over New Albany. Lily Goldberg has a stellar hit in their doubles match against Marysville. Kendra Sheehan has a nice pass to Grace McCarthy to beat Worthington Kilbourne. This has been Kylie Casey reporting for WARL.
UA Sports. It's in the game.
It's only a matter of time before we see those players on SportsCenter. Now let's kick it back to the future to Cade.
Welcome to Sports Live. I'm Kate. In UA Sports News, senior Dane Goodwin and junior Matthew Kramer are currently leading the boys' golf team to a 14-1 record and top position in the OCC. The girls' golf team has won all three of their OCC matches and have their last one on Tuesday. On Wednesday night, the Field Hockey Bears beat New Albany 1-0. Sophomore Sophie Croce scored the game-winning goal to get their second win of the season. Last night, the boys' soccer team beat Canal Winchester in their first win of the season. Seniors Nico Slattery and Noah Mitchell scored. Senior Ryan Burke says the open to their schedule was the hardest in the OCC, but they're trusting the process and plan to pick it up and end the season well. Also last night, the girls' volleyball team beat Hilliard-Davidson in three sets. Their next home game is Thursday against Marysville. Now back to Dugan with a look at the Bear Den.
Bear Den is basically the student section of any Upper Arlington High School sporting event, and we meet every Wednesday after school in the first floor OC.
Bear Den helps coordinate stunts like these. If you can't make the Bear Den meetings, you can always show your support at any of our sporting events. This has been Dugan Turner for WARL.
Great job, and thanks to everyone that helped to make the first Bear Den stunt a success. The meetings are Wednesdays after school in the first floor LC. All students are encouraged to attend. After a 21-31 loss to Westerville Central last week, the football team plans to return to dominance tonight at Westerville North. The theme is a blackout. Good luck, boys. This week, seniors Andrew Pema and Maddie Meath both committed to play lacrosse in college. Pema will be playing for Ohio Wesleyan, and Meath will be playing for Kent State. Big congratulations to both of you. And now let's kick it to Madeline Olivia with Lifestyle.
Hi, welcome to Lifestyle. I'm Madeline.
And I'm Olivia. On Wednesday, Activision released the video game Destiny 2 for Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and Microsoft Windows.
The game has already sold millions of copies and was the number one pre-ordered video game in the U.S. based off of unit sales.
Based off of the tired eyes from some boys around the high school, the new multiplayer first-person shooter game has taken its effect.
Speaking of dudes being dudes, today on Lifestyle, Dudent Section makes its grand return to Kickin' It Live. Tommy and Josh have it covered. Let's take a look.
It's Dudent Section with Josh and Tommy.
Welcome to Dudent Section today, guys. We're going to number one Happy House Chinese restaurant today, hoping for some good food.
Yeah, it's been getting a bad rap lately. Just going to go check it out, see if it's legit.
Now that we're here, let's see if this restaurant is really legit.
The best pad thai you've ever had?
I tried several locations, but I consider mine. I think yours is
two pad thais, please. Tommy, I don't know about you, but I'm really feeling some good pad thai.
Yeah, I was promised my socks to be knocked off, so if anything less, I'll be disappointed. We just got a line, and you know what that means.
It's time to line it up.
First bite, you know, just gotta get a big bite. It's hot.
Let's test out the beef.
Beef test for the boys, and then we hit it.
That beef's pretty good.
It's pretty high quality.
Student sections.
I guess you could say we were happy with Happy House.
The shadiest restaurant on Fifth Avenue exceeded all my expectations and is a good spot to have lunch with your friends. This has been Josh Cole for WARL.
Looks like they're making the Dudent Section great again. On another food note, for the donut lovers out there, Krispy Kreme is bringing back its pumpkin spice glazed donut for today only.
If you're looking for something to do on Sunday, come out and see Catherine Arend, Olivia Sicuti, Courtney Caparos, Nicole Claceres, and Gwyneth Whitcomb's senior capstone show, Home, at UAHS Auditorium.
Doors will open at 6:30 and the show will start at 7. Admission is free, but you will have the opportunity to donate to the Youth Empowerment Program.
Next Thursday, the senior summer capstone presentations take place from 6 to 8 p.m. There will be 39 presenters out of the 75 who originally planned on completing it in their proposals.
For the 36 of you not finished and those left to go on January 16th and April 14th dates, it's all up from here.
Now let's kick it back to Sydney and Nick at Maine.
Juniors and seniors, make sure to check out the list of upcoming college visits in the Family Connection and then sign up for any you are interested in the College Center.
These visits will provide you with the opportunity to ask reps from colleges specific questions about campus life, admissions, scholarships, and more in a smaller setting.
Breakaway Music Festival swept through the capital city this past weekend. We take a look at what went into organizing this annual fest.
Despite the inclement weather that surrounded Central Ohio, Breakaway Music
Breakaway Music Festival is a two-day music festival here in Columbus, Ohio. It's our flagship music festival that we do. We do a number of music festivals all across the country, even the world, kind of as far as Barcelona. And as close as Columbus, Ohio. So Prime Social Group always tries to bring kind of the hottest artists of the time. So we look at the younger demographic, skews pretty younger, and the demographic of like 16 to like 35 maybe, anything that those people tend to listen to. So we did change our venue multiple times here. The main thing that you run in Columbus, Ohio is finding a venue that can service 10,000 plus people safely and in a good way, and you kind of come across only a few different spots around the city. We got kind of creative. There's different fields and empty areas in the city, warehouses and whatnot, but we had a good relationship with the Columbus crew. They're great people, and we had done our year one there, but we wanted to do something a little different, so we did it outside of the actual soccer stadium.
For WARL, this has been Nick Biziano
and Sydney Lowe. Prime Social's Haunted Fest will take place October 27th at the Ohio Expo Center. The lineup includes Hardwell, Kungs, and more.
Bears, Spirit Week starts Monday. Start off the week by wearing your favorite pajamas to school. For many of you, that means wearing your regular Monday attire.
While Monday will be a day to dress casual, homecoming next Saturday requires a more formal dress code. Now for the much-anticipated moment, let's announce who made this year's homecoming court.
Okay. This year's nominees are La La Land. Wait, what?
Nick, that's not homecoming court. And the winner was Moonlight anyways. Maybe our student council representatives can set the record straight for us. Casey DeWalt, student council social chair, is working hard to plan gnomecoming.
She's in the studio this morning with fellow student council representative Jake Carlin to help announce the homecoming court.
Congratulations to all of the homecoming court nominees.
The senior girl nominees are Mimi Kai, Hannah Caldwell, Avery Clark, Zenobia Chris, Rachel Feinberg, and Kate Gomez.
The senior boys court is Jimmy Kentakis, Dante Landolfi, Cole Tingley, Manny Sigurnis, and Adam Wade. Congratulations.
And now back to Sydney and Nick to the end of the show.
Thanks, Jake and Casey. Next week, we'll take a look at Spirit Week, homecoming, what not to wear, and another UA top three.
And just so you know, on Jupiter and Saturn, it rains diamonds. So make it rain this weekend, Bears.